I started my professional journey as a solicitor and worked at Clayton Utes for 3 years in M&A and project finance before joining Macquarie's investment banking group in early 2004. And I spent nearly a decade with Macquarie in Melbourne and New York, working across a range of industry groups. I then joined Flagstaff Partners, which is a leading Australian investment corporate finance advisor in 2011, and I was an equity partner and managing director there. So my journey, my professional journey, has been a short period as a solicitor. The last two decades has been as an investment banker, and I think the key attribute to the Catalyst Fund is not my skill set in isolation, it's a combination of my skill set with Mark and Raffi's skill set as who's had two decades of stock picking experience, and combining that skill set to be the three members of the investment committee for the Catalyst Fund. The idea for the Catalyst Fund came about through Raffi, Mark and myself knowing each other for a couple of decades, and we thought there was a unique proposition in combining their stock picking skills with my investment banking skills, and bringing those skill sets together on an investment committee and a decision-making committee for the Catalyst Fund. So we formed the Catalyst Fund on the 1st of July 2021. We are seeking to achieve genuine alpha to the ASX 200 index. That is why we have got a hard cap of 10 stocks in the Catalyst Fund. Now, the fund is a best ideas fund of the L1 Capital Long Short Fund, but with an activist overlay. So again, by definition, we think once you get greater than 10 stocks, you start to not satisfy the definition of a best ideas fund. And because activism is so time consuming and labor intensive, again, that's why we've capped our stocks at 10. And finally, we aren't suggesting to our investor universe that they invest 100% of their portfolio in the Catalyst Fund. It's a sleeve or a part of their overall portfolio, which is going to, seek to generate genuine alpha to the market. There's three what I'll describe as gates in order for the stocks to get into the Catalyst Fund. The first gate is the value gate. It needs to meet the value expectations of the long short, investment approach. Quality, it needs to meet the quality gate for the L1 Capital Long Short Fund. So they're the same two gates as for the Long Short Fund. But then the third gate, which is the unique gate, and that is the Catalyst Gate. And Catalyst, can really be things that might be operational related, might be governance related, that we can influence or enact and accelerate these catalysts to bring forward equity returns for investors. And it's that third gate which is going to be different to what the long short funds investment mindset will think about. Raffi, Mark and myself sit on the investment committee for the Catalyst Fund. For any stock to go into the portfolio, all three of us need to agree and there needs to be unanimous consent. And the thought process there is that we've got a best ideas fund. If one of the three of us do not agree for any particular reason, we think that it doesn't therefore satisfy the definition of a best ideas fund, and then that stock does not go into the portfolio. What's changed in the last 12 months is the macro backdrop. We're not a macro fund, but of course we have regard to the macro backdrop because it influences markets so materially. The opportunity set has changed a little bit in the last 12 months because of the significant increase in the risk-free rate, as well as having some regard to some of the geopolitical tensions around the world and the flow-on effects that is having to markets and countries. So because we are so stock-specific in our selection, we have regard to the macro backdrop, but it's dependent on the situation and the opportunities relating to that stock and the value and the quality and the catalyst which could be enacted and accelerated in relation to that particular stock. We've exited out of three or four positions that were in the portfolio when we initiated it on the 1st of July last year. One stock I'll refer to that has been that we brought into the portfolio in the first year of the Catalyst Fund is Ramsay Healthcare. We liked Ramsay because it had a high quality, irreplaceable set of hospital assets up and down the eastern seaboard in Australia and also in the northern hemisphere. It was trading at a discount to the ASX Industrials Index from a PE perspective. Historically, it had traded at a premium because of the high quality, irreplaceable set of hospitals. Importantly though, it had a number of potential catalysts. It had a joint venture in Malaysia, which was not being valued at all by the market, but primarily the real value unlock was the property assets that it owned in Australia that were largely freehold and were owned up and down the eastern seaboard. They were an irreplaceable set of hospital assets, and we thought there was a value unlock opportunity to the tune of, you know, valuing these property assets at circa $9 to $10 billion at a time when the market capitalization of Ramsay was only $15 billion, entering into a sale and lease back type of transaction and utilizing some of those proceeds to buy back shares at a time when the Ramsay share price was, in our view, undervalued.